Hey, my name is Bruce, and recently I entered a contest with one of my favorite YouTubers, Mark Rinaldi. I'm sorry. Yeah, that's right. Mark Rinaldi of 8-Minute Axe. I recommend everybody subscribe to his channel. Plays 12-string guitar and 6-string guitar, does an awesome job, makes awesome videos, and he's just a really nice guy. So he has a contest every month. Every month he gives away a guitar, and I'm like, I never win anything, but I won this time, and it came via Amazon. This, I believe, is a 12-string guitar from Vangoa. They're inexpensive 12-string guitars. They're $200. Where can you get a 12-string guitar for $200? It's like nowhere. They're made in China, but I thought I'd open this up and see what it was. Got this. And here it is. You think there's actually a 12-string guitar in here? Let's see how it comes. It's got a gig bag. It's got an accessory kit. Let's see what it looks like. There's got to be a zipper pull on here. Oh, here it is. Yeah, looking like a 12-string guitar. Gig bag, kind of nice. It's got kind of the thin nylon to it. It's got straps. Well packaged, no damage shipping it from Amazon and all the heck away from China. Ta-da! 12-string guitar. Now I'm cheating a little bit because I already did open this, and so I already know. I'll save you some time and be some editing. There are some issues with the guitar. First of all, just overall, the thing is beautiful. Shiny, glossy. The neck is straight. The action is excellent. For $200, it's a 12-string guitar. The things that I noticed when I opened it before, the only bad things I can notice are the fret ends. Can you zoom in on the fret ends somehow? Right here.
I can't.
Okay. They're really sharp. I mean, we're talking cut your finger sharp. They've shaved them over nicely this way, but there are burrs on the edges of the frets. If you're going to get one of these, I would also get a fret file and go ahead and masking tape off the frets and dress these fret ends. The other thing is, once it came up to tension, the action so far is staying nice and low. There's a slight dive in the fretboard right as it gets to the sound hole. Doesn't affect playability for those of us who just pound out cowboy chords up here on the end of the neck, but it just doesn't inspire confidence. And the top deck has taken a little bit of a wave. Comes down here toward the sound hole, and then up at the bridge. Probably okay. It's got a plywood top, but this sounds pretty good for a guitar with a plywood top. It's got no tuner in it, but it does have a battery and an equalizer, and it's an electric. It's got a piezo under the bridge, and it's got an output jack. I would say for someone who's going to pay $200 and wants a 12-string, this is danged good. You know, I have a Seagull 12, which was $550. Sounds a little better quality, but not everyone wants to pay $550 for a 12-string guitar. A lot of people use their 12-string guitars less than they use their 6-strings. So this Vangoa, it's pretty interesting. Now, you know, I have nothing against Chinese people. I want them to be prosperous and well. So I don't have a problem buying from Chinese people. I do have concerns about the Chinese Communist Party. And everything's a mix these days, unfortunately, of governments and people. But you get to decide for yourself how you feel about that. I do want to highlight this accessory kit because it's just generous. This cute little snarky tuner, the darn thing feels cheap on the outside, but it's good and it works just fine. And that's in there. There's a strap, and this has strap buttons on it. There's an electric cable. I'm told there is a 9-volt battery in there, and then this came with a little button cell battery, so you don't need to buy any batteries. Microfiber cloth from Vangoa. You can stick on this little pick guard if you want to stick on the pick guard. Some people don't like that. Extra strings. Truss rod wrench. Truss rod was nicely adjusted. Comes with a piece of sandpaper. Do I know what the sandpaper's for? Roughing up the back of the neck? I don't know, but it's a nice piece of sandpaper. It'll probably tell me if I read the instructions. Capo. Now this is a plastic capo. Can it possibly work? I have no idea. But this guitar comes with a capo. Kind of cool. What do you want for nothing, huh? Three picks, and two extra bridge pins. So this is my conclusion. You know, Vangoa has the advantage of cheap labor in China. And they've made a guitar that's surprisingly good for $200. So if you're in the market for a cheap, I shouldn't say cheap, that's kind of disparaging, for an inexpensive 12-string guitar and you want to buy new, this is not bad. If you can get a used guitar, often the 12-string guitars you get in pawn shops and secondhand stores, the action is incredibly high because with these 12-string guitars, the string tension is really high and the action goes. If you don't want to hassle, if you just want to get a guitar that's going to be playable, consider the Vangoa. $200, you know, it's not a Ferrari, it's a Yugo, but this Yugo will play. Just, I think the big thing, and this is something that Vangoa should be made aware of, they need to dress these fret ends because it's not just harsh. There's little slivers of metal that could poke your fingers. Maybe that's what the sandpaper's for. They want you to sand off your own. You're supposed to use a file for that. Anyway, that's the end of my video. Thanks for listening. Play on. And definitely subscribe to Mark Arredelli's channel on YouTube, which is 8-Minute Axe. He does good stuff. Thanks. Bye.